There's a meal at your store right now that is so wonderful and decadent, yet it's so hard for anyone to conceive that such a thing would be enjoyable. It's been a staple in literary culture for decades and even centuries, and no good can come of it. There it is, in its satisfying deliciousness, at less than 2 bits a serving. Now, no one that I asked today has ever even tried gruel, yet they are so quick to insult it. Young or old, it's not even a thing. It's not even talked about unless it's prodding at the lifestyle of 19th century orphans. Yet it is fascinating that we are overlooking it. I mean, people eat porridge and oatmeal and grits and cream of wheat as a common staple, and rice is yet almost mandatory in most Asian countries, but why not gruel? Is it the name? And why is it that grinding oatmeal into a powder and adding a bit more water is such a sin? Just like some scotches, a little water can bring out so much in grains, and sometimes more is better. It really brings out the creamy and robust characteristics of them, and it can appease almost all palates. I mean, adding a small bit of sugar to an oat gruel, or perhaps a little maple syrup, can even make your breakfast into a sweet delight that can make even the most picky child eater sing like he's eating some sugary cereal. A little salt and butter can please even the most diehard savory palates. The staple food of Western diet for centuries through millet and hemp seed was more common, but thanks to the spoils of the free market, all sorts of grains are at our fingertips, even in ground forms. Whole grain flour could be a wonderful experience with just a little bit of tomato juice. Corn gruel with some chili powder and some mayo and Parmesan cheese is a creamy dish to go with a little bit of Mexican flair. However, my personal favorite is adding just a little bit of soy sauce and some sriracha sauces to a rice gruel, and it makes somewhat of an Asian-inspired breakfast. In an age where we're supposed to pay through the nose for eggs because of the recent bird flu epidemic, I mean, people are seeking alternatives. I mean, the price signal is all over the map, yet one of the most best and affordable options isn't even being considered because of the negative connotations that Charles Dickens applies. Charles Dickens, who was responsible for the spread of post-medieval ethics, is also to blame for the damnation of a vital and delicious part of our history. I think it's time that we should reclaim our history and our pleasure from that statist mindset that tries to hide this wonderful dish from our love of fine dining. It is time to bring back our love of grains and from the paleo and Atkins school of thought and cozy up to a fire, having a good bourbon and coffee and a hot cup of gruel.